Hey, all right, government class, day six. Yesterday, you looked at five very notable philosophers and their basic philosophies that impacted United States and our government. I just want to kind of give you today in the lesson just kind of a quick case study of what I mean by America not coming up with all of the ideas that we have in our government. So we're going to zero in on the Bill of Rights, which we learned about a couple lessons ago. And remember, that's the first 10 amendments, right? The first 10 changes or additions that we made to our Constitution. And that has things like, freedom of speech, the right to bear arms, the right to privacy, the right to a jury trial. Those, again, 10 basic freedoms or limits on government. So, again, America didn't come up with those. Again, we're the first to kind of write them out and set them in stone in our document that runs our government. But we weren't the ones that came up with many of those ideas. Most of those ideas actually come from the Magna Carta, which was a document that King John had to sign, King John of England, had to sign way back in 1215. And then some of those traditions carried on in British history. And since we were British colonies at first, right, before we revolted and started our independent nation, we then took some of those ideas and put them into our Bill of Rights. So what you're going to do is you're going to compare the two documents today. I've given you just short sections of the Magna Carta, very short. And you need to then figure out which of the 10 amendments in the Bill of Rights did it influence. And it's possible that there could be, for a couple of them, like two different amendments, right? I mean, you don't necessarily have to have both. I mean, you could, right? But you need to at least match up at least one amendment that section of the Magna Carta influenced. So that's kind of your first assignment. And then the second assignment, which both of these are short, the second assignment is to look at a primary source called Federalist 47. And this is about a half-page document that is going to defend the newly written Constitution, and it's going to be used to transition us to our next section of lessons, which is going to talk about how the three branches of government work. And so that document's going to talk about the three branches and what was needed to make sure that they were a functioning but not too powerful of a government. And so again, there's two parts of the assignment today. Right, they're detailed out in Schoology like always, but you're going to look at two documents, the Magna Carta and then Federalist 47. All right, keep up the good work. Right, lots of you have been turning in a bunch of stuff in. Really appreciate it. Hopefully this will come to an end soon, but at least for the next, roughly six or seven lessons, this is the way it's going to be. So continue to email me, text me if you have questions.